Here, we test your knowledge of JavaScript environments and scope, along with a little bit of info on native North American peoples. As the text of the problem suggests, we're going to solve it by working out the nested environment diagrams. So let's start with the global environment. In the global environment, we define a function Apache, and the first thing we do is call it with the inputs 9 and 10. So this is going to create a new environment for that function call of Apache. The inputs were 9, which corresponds to Iroquois. The second was 10, which corresponds to Ottawa. We then set Seneca to 1, and we declare and set Creek to 2. When we print out Seneca, we're going to look at the lowest environment, which is Apache. We see Seneca is 1. Iroquois is 9. Ottawa is 10. We now declare a function Cherokee, and we call it with the inputs 777 and 888. Since we're going into a new function, we create a new environment. 777 gets assigned to Seneca, which is a local variable, and Creek gets a value of 888. We print out Seneca, which at the closest scope is 777. We then print out Iroquois. It's not in the scope of Cherokee, so we go up to Apache, and Iroquois is defined as 9. We now print out Ottawa. Ottawa is not defined here in Cherokee, but is defined in Apache as 10. And lastly, we're going to print out Creek. Same deal, not defined in Cherokee, but is in Apache. Now we do some modifications. We set Seneca to 33. We set Creek to 44. We set Iroquois to 55. It's not in Cherokee, so we're changing the value of Iroquois in the Apache environment. Then we set Ottawa. We leave this function, and now we're printing out Seneca. Since we've left the Cherokee function, this environment no longer applies, and we're simply looking at what's in Apache. The value of Seneca is 1, the value of Iroquois is 55, the value of Ottawa is 66, the value of Creek is 2.